One of my favorite productivity tools recently made a very big announcement, so I want to make sure you know all about it. In this video, I'm going to share why this change to the Walling Free Plan is such a big deal. I'm going to give you a quick review of what Walling is and what it's best used for, and of course, some of my personal favorite features. So let's dive in. First things first, let's talk about the big announcement. Now, Walling has always had a free forever plan. However, you were limited to a total number of 100 bricks. Now, bricks in Walling really refer to any entity within the workspace. So here I've got a collection of notes. Here I've got some tasks. Maybe I've got some files and images. Each individual one would be counted as a brick. Now, that's probably fine for one or two workspaces or one or two projects, but that's probably going to limit you in the long run. Now, Walling has removed that limitation so you can work with unlimited bricks. So now you can brainstorm and collaborate till your heart's content and never reach a limit with the number of things you add. The only limitation you may want to keep in mind is that you have a total of 10 free walls, think of workspaces, to work with. And for many of you, that might be all that you need. So with that limitation out of the way, let's take a look at some of Walling's key features. Now, at first glance, you may think that Walling looks an awful lot like Notion, but I don't think that's a very fair comparison. Yes, Walling is very flexible, but one of the complaints I continue to hear about Notion is that it is too freeform. People are often worried that they're going to break something, that they're going to ruin something, and they don't necessarily like dealing with a completely blank page. But here within Walling, I would say that the feel is a lot more convenient and also a lot more faster, very similar to something like Google Keep. So if I want to add a new note, I can double click anywhere and add it and then move it to anywhere else that I like. And very similar to something like Keep, we can change the color, we can assign people, assign due dates, and assign reminders directly to that note, task, idea, file, image, whatever it is you want it to represent here within Walling. The other fantastic feature here within Walling is that it's really easy to organize everything together. You'll see that I've broken down this particular wall into a number of different sections, including goals, copywriting, target audience. I've got a few files and even some images here at the bottom. But if I really want to focus, I can easily collapse some of these sections and just focus on a particular area itself. And this can be great, especially if I want to keep my views very different between those sections. So for example, under target audience, I've got this information just listed in sort of a traditional visual block style. But if I want to, I can convert anything into a Kanban board, for example. So maybe I want to move things through a different process, I can do so. If I want to come up here and view this as a traditional list, I can do that as well. If I want to add due dates and view a calendar, I can change and go back and forth. Or if I like a more traditional table or almost database style view, I can do that here as well and have that custom view right beside something else that can be very, very different. Speaking of keeping things at the forefront and nice, big, and bold, if you deal with a number of images, Walling is a fantastic choice. In so many different project management and other productivity tools, the images or attachments are often buried beneath a card or beneath a task. But here, you can keep your images up front. So for example, I've got a number of images here under inspirations, and if I click on any one of them, I get a nice big preview to deal with. And I can work in this mode as well. So it's more than just a preview. I can add comments and collaborate collaborate with others. So if you're dealing in marketing, if you're dealing in graphic design, mockups, or anything that deals with a number of images, Wally may be a fantastic solution for you. Now, another personal favorite feature of mine is how easy it is to share your information and share your walls with others. Now, here at the top of my workspace, I'm going to select share. And of course, I can invite others by the traditional method of sending them an email invitation. And yes, walling allows us to change the level of ability for those different users. But what if I want to share something with a client or someone that doesn't need direct access to my wall? I can give a shareable link here at the top of the screen. And the great thing here is that it's going to be a view-only link. So I don't have to worry about others editing or making changes to this wall, but maybe I can update a client as to what is going on or explain as to what we are thinking about with the new project that we are engaged in. So instead of forcing someone to create a login and to learn how to use a new tool that they may not use again, or at least not in some time, Walling makes it super easy to share that information. In addition, Walling gives us some flexible ways in which we can view our information. If I click on the dashboard here on the left-hand side, here you can see I have my four different projects in a Kanban board of their own. So I can keep track of things at a high level and then go back down to that granular level whenever I want to. And then, of course, at the top of the screen, I can also click on assign and get a clear view as to what is overdue and what I should be focusing on next. So if you're needing to keep your team on the same page, Walling can be an excellent choice. Now, if you like the sound of free tools that can do a lot for you, be sure to click on this video next, where I show you how to create a free user guide in just a matter of seconds.